गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल. माई सेल्फ आलोक, योर मॉडल साइंस टीचर, एंड आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू इन टूडेज मॉडल साइंस क्लास. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन टूडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन अ लेसन नंबर 7, द फुटबॉल मैच. ऑलरेडी वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड आवर पोर्शन. ओके, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू द लेसन नंबर 7, the football match. In today's class we are not going to do more, just today we will read the lesson because it is quite a big lesson. So we will read the lesson nicely and try to understand it, and you will try to complete the question answer also. So here is a lesson. Now everyone please try to understand the lesson nicely. Here it is given: the next day there is a football match between Bhumi and the neighboring village, about 3 kilometers away. What happened in last class? Let me remind you that in last class we have studied that Chisimba, he stayed with Mulenga's family and there for the dinner, and he had lots of talk regarding so many topics. Okay, and then Mulenga is explaining to Chisimba that your situation will change and you will able to complete your study. After that, in this chapter it is explained, the next day there is a football match between Bhumi and the neighboring village. Okay, next day what is happening? There is a football match between Bhumi, that village of where Musunda is living, Musunda's village, and neighboring village about 3 kilometers away. From there, Bhumi 3 kilometers away, there is match. Godwin and Chisimba belongs to Bhumi's football team, and the whole family decides to go and watch the game. Okay, Chisimba and that Godwin both belongs to Bhumi's football team. And because of that they will play, so whole family decides to go and watch the game. Okay, go and watch the game. Musunda's grandparents live in the neighboring village, so the family will spend the morning with them, and then they will all go to the match in the afternoon. They set out on foot early in the morning. What happened? They have decided, Musunda's grandparents, okay, they live in the neighboring village. In the neighboring village, Musunda's grandparents, they were living. Okay, so what happened? What is the plan of the family? So the family will spend the morning with them, with that grandparents' house they will spend, and then they will go to watch the match in the afternoon. So they have decided like this. So they set out on foot early in the morning. Early in the morning, whole family, they set out on the foot, means they start walking towards that village. Okay. Now next it is explained here. As soon as they arrive at the home of Musunda's grandparents, Godwin and Chisimba rush off to prepare for the game. Okay, as soon as they have arrived the Musunda's grandparents' house, Godwin and Chisimba both they rush off to prepare for the game. For the game they have gone to prepare for practice the match. Okay, Roj and Musunda stayed to help their grandmother. Roj and Musunda, what they are doing? They stay there to help their grandmother. Okay, and when they finish, they go around the village with Musunda's younger brother and gather together a few children. First they helped grandmother, and then after finishing those work, what happened? They go around the village they have gone, and with Musunda's younger brother, and gather together a few children. Okay, they bring them back to their grandparents' home. After collecting those children, what they have done? They have brought all the children to grandparents' house, and have a class with them. With them, they had Musunda and Rose. They had a class. Rose teaches them songs and a beautiful quotation. Later, their grandmother gives them a cool, sweet drink, and then the children all run back to their homes. What happened? That Rose, what she is teaching? She teaches a song and a beautiful quotation to the children. And after, later on, the grandmother, she gives all the children a cool, sweet drink. That is called sarbat in Hindi. Okay, cool, sweet drink, and then the children all run back to their homes. It is time for lunch. Now it is time for lunch. Okay. Musunda's mother and grandmother have prepared a wonderful meal. Musunda's grandmother and mother together, they have prepared a wonderful meal for everyone. And slowly everyone appears around the table. Slowly all the members of the family, and they are appearing around the table for the, you know, meal. Her grandfather and father came in off the field. Means that Musunda's grandfather and father, they are coming from where? They are coming from the field. Come in off the field. And Godwin and Chisimba arrive back from practice. And Godwin and Chisimba, they are coming from the practice of match. The whole family is getting excited about the match. Means whole family is excited about the match. Okay, that what will happen in the match. Don't eat too much. They tell the boys, you have to play later. Okay, that do not eat much. They are saying to the boys, do not eat much because you have to play later. So because of that, don't eat much. In the mid-afternoon when the match begins, Bhumi scores the first point. Bhumi scores the first goal or first point and is ahead throughout the match. Okay, they were ahead. At beginning only, the Bhumi scored first point, means first goal, and throughout the match they were ahead. But the other team, the neighboring team, scores 2 points in the last 15 minutes of the game to win. So, but what happened at the last time, last moment, the neighboring village, they have scored 2 goals or 2 points. Okay, last 15 minutes. And they won the match. Minutes of the game to win. It is a day of much excitement. And then whole the day was passed with much excitement. Everyone was, match was so excited. Everyone has enjoyed. Okay. One hour before dark, the family starts back for Bhumi. Whole family, they starts back, walk back to Bhumi. They have not walked for far before they see at a distance a woman carrying firewood on her head. Means they have not started very far. That time what they are seeing? A woman, she was carrying some firewood on her head. As she gets closer, they can tell that the firewood is heavy and that she is tired. Means as the old woman, she comes closer, okay, they can see that, okay, as she gets closer, they can tell that the firewood is heavy and she is tired. Everyone can notice that firewood is too heavy and she is tired. Godwin and Chisimba immediately offers to help. Okay, when they are seeing that she is tired and the firewood is so heavy, so Godwin and Chisimba immediately offer to help her. She thanks them. Okay, she thanks them. They take the firewood to the woman's home. What they are doing? That Godwin and Chisimba, they take the firewood to the woman's home while the rest of the family continues on the road for Bhumi. And rest of the family, they continued walking to the Bhumi, but the Godwin and Sisimba, they have gone to woman's house, old woman's house, okay, with the firewood. After helping the woman, Godwin and Sisimba turned back for Bhumi. After helping that woman, okay, Godwin and Sisimba, they turned back for Bhumi again. They are full of energy and decide to try to get home before everyone else. Okay, they are, after helping the woman, means both Godwin and Simba, they are full of energy and they are decide to go home before everyone else reach, they should reach the home. I know a shortcut through the fields. Okay, say Chisimba. Chisimba is saying that I know a shortcut through the fields. Follow me. And off they go. When the family arrives home, they find Godwin and Chisimba standing at the door, tired but smiling. Okay, as the whole family is reaching home, what they are finding that Godwin and Chisimba, already they are standing at the door, tired but smiling. So in this manner, this story is over, students. Now in today's class, I'm not going to discuss you here the question and answer. We will discuss the question and answer in next class, but in today's class, up to here only is there, and you will try to complete the question answer yourself first, but in next class we will discuss the question answer. So the home assignment is like this: read lesson 7 nicely and try to understand lesson 7, this whole lesson, once or twice, read nicely and try to understand. And next homework is there: complete the question and answer of lesson 7 in your book. In your book only, try to complete the question and answer. In next class we will discuss the question and answer again, then you can match whether the question, your means whatever answer you have written, it is right or wrong. Okay, so now I'm going to end the class. This is all for today's class. Thank you students. Bye. Have a nice day.